Today on this Friday, May 11th, 2012, seniors are proudly dressed in their blue Bon Voyage shirts for these last couple of weeks here at DV. Next Friday is their last day of high school and they only have one thing to say. I'm Elena Mendoza, thanks for joining us. This is DVTV. Seniors, today is the day to wear your senior breakfast shirt. Pick up your senior breakfast shirt for free in the bookstore today. You will wear this shirt again during senior breakfast after the mandatory graduation practice at 7:45 a.m. on Thursday, May 24th. There's another mandatory graduation meeting on Monday, May 21st at 8:30 a.m. in the Dr. Joe McDonald Auditorium. Please contact Ms. Barella if you have any questions about these dates. For other important dates, check out our website under Seniors Important Information. Also, please remember to follow all school rules and policies when you are on campus next week for the meetings and returning books, as we want to see all of you at graduation. Earlier this spring, several members of the DV Quiz Bowl team took the 2012 National Medusa Mythology Examination, Malicious Monsters and Monstrous Mortals, and they just received the good news about their scores. Please congratulate Hong Fan Wang for achieving a gold medal and qualifying to compete for the Homer Award for 2012. Also, congratulations to seniors Annie Huang for earning the silver medal and Brandon DeJaya for earning the Corona Olive Award for exceeding the national average. The $2 t-shirt blowout sale is still going on the bookstore. Get championship football shirts, spring fling shirts, and 2012 class shirts. Come by the bookstore and pick one up before they are all gone. With the end of the school year coming up, please make a note of a couple very important items for those of you who will be coming back to Desert Vista next year. First, check out the summer newsletter on the School Fusion website at the beginning of June. It has very important information including book distribution days, potential schedule changes, and updates to the school calendar. Also, there will be a few changes next year in the way you change your schedule. The blue card schedule process. Starting at book distribution time, if you want to change your schedule, you will need to fill out a blue card, and your parent or guardian will need to sign it. You might see some changes around the cafeteria next year, as we have received our heritage grant from Game and Fish for $9,555. This is going toward landscaping the large area between the gym and the cafeteria. Native plants are also going into this landscape, along with a bench sponsored by groups, clubs, and families. Chase Bokey has the story.
Recently, Monte Vista Elementary School and Altadena Middle School have changed their look from dry landscapes to plant-filled gardens. Some students at DV had a similar idea.
For our senior year, we got opted to help work on a landscape project. I'm sure everybody has seen the this strip of land right here. It's just a bunch of sand. It's really boring, it's ugly, and it does nothing but trap water. So our plan was to build like a desert landscape within here, something that uses conserved water, something that will make a nice place for people to sit and enjoy their lunch, and also reduce the urban heat island effect on Desert Vista.
So the urban heat island effect is where we have a lot of asphalt and buildings that when the light comes down, it doesn't reflect the heat, it traps it. So it actually makes this area more hot. If we were to have more plants, then the light would reflect out into the atmosphere and it would reduce the heat. And also it would be more aesthetically pleasing, which means it would be more beautiful and kids could enjoy their lunch here and even research the plants.
The school has received a grand total of $19,555 along with other donations to get this project started, so look forward to a much greener, cooler courtyard in the future. For DVTV, I'm Ben Jimenez.
Thank you, Chase. Today we have a special guest in the studio, Mark Trujillo, to tell us more about an upcoming club that is all about anti-bullying. Let's go to reporter Brooke Sirak.
Thank you, Elena, so much. Joining us right now is Mark Trujillo to tell us a little more about this club. First off, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Of course. Can we start by just asking, what is the goal of this club and what is the name of the club? And just tell me a little bit about it.
The name of the club is called Love is Louder Than Bullying, and it's an anti-bullying club. And my goal for this club is to raise awareness about bullying and the effects of it and what it causes and how much of an impact it makes on a person emotionally, mentally, and physically.
Of course. And who is this club created for specifically?
The club is created for anyone who has been bullied or is even being a bully, because if you're a bully to someone, whether it's cyberbullying or just verbal abuse in general, then you can learn the effects of bullying and the stuff that it causes on a person. And pretty much it.
Of course, and we've seen kind of some of the effects recently. There were reports with Mitt Romney, nearly five different people confirmed that when he was in high school, he was a bully himself. And we saw that bullying kind of follows you, not just in high school, but it can follow you for the rest of your life. What was your response to this as a leader of this club?
My response to it is that it is mean, and it, even though it happened 40 years ago, then it can still follow you. And some of the stuff that he did in high school still happens today. So bullying, it hasn't really changed.
Of course, it's kind of an endless cycle that needs to be stopped. And why did you decide to start this?
I decided to start it because ever since the third grade, I have been severely bullied. So I've had that experience. And also, with the causes of bullying, there's self-harm, eating disorders. Even it leads to a point where you commit suicide. And that has happened. The suicide rate has gone up, and it's mostly because of bullying. Mm-hmm. And I've experienced with all that stuff, so it's kind of like I'm there for people, and I know what it's like to feel alone. I know what all that stuff is like. So, yeah.
And finally, why should someone from DV join this club?
Someone from DV should join this club because it's a club where you can go to and you're not alone. Like, there's other people in this school where they're going through the same issues that you are. And, so it's kind of like you're not alone. Like, you can share your story. You know, it's a club where you shouldn't be afraid to stand up and speak up about your issues and, you know, reach out for help even. Like, that's kind of like a coping method.
So. Thank you so much for joining us. We're looking forward to seeing what this club will bring to us in the coming years.
Thank you.
Back to you, Elena.
One last announcement for all track and field athletes not competing. You must turn in your uniforms to Danny in the equipment room immediately. Have a great weekend, Thunder. Join us Monday for our final DVTV of the year.